And now, it's time for another Dice Tower Review with Tom Vasel.
Today we're talking about Smash Up. Smash Up is a new game from AEG by Paul Peterson, which basically lets you take everything and make it fight everything else. Now, it's not the first time we've seen that theme. We've seen it in HeroScape and Duel of Ages and such. But this is a very light card game in which you'll be able to take different factions and mix them together and fight against other factions. It sounds more complicated. It isn't. It's a very simple game. Let's take a look. At the beginning of the game, each player is going to choose two of the eight factions. More factions are coming, but there's eight factions, and you're going to pick two and put them together. So, you can have alien dinosaurs, alien ninjas, alien pirates, alien robots, alien tricksters, alien wizards, and alien zombies, or dinosaur ninjas, dinosaur robots, dinosaur pirates, dinosaur tricksters, dinosaur wizards, dinosaur zombies, or ninja pirates. What? Ninja robots, ninja tricksters, ninja wizards, ninja zombies, pirate robots, pirate tricksters, pirate wizards, or zombie pirates. Robot tricksters, robot wizards, that sounds cool, robot zombies, trickster wizards, or trickster zombies, huh? Or wizard zombies. I guess that would make more sense, zombie wizards. What you're going to do, each of these decks has kind of a theme to it, a special thing, but you'll pick two. So let's see, we'll put together pirates and dinosaurs, all right? Pirates riding dinosaurs. These aren't any dinosaurs. And what you'll do is you're going to shuffle those two decks together, and that is going to be the deck that you will be using for the game. So everyone's going to have two decks that they will use. And another deck is going to be shuffled, and this deck is made up of locations. And you'll see each location has three giant numbers and a special ability down. These three giant numbers are points for first, second, and third place, and the text at the bottom is a special ability. So you're going to put a number of these out in the middle of the table equal to the number of players plus one. So in a three-player game, I would put four of those out. Each player is going to draw five cards from their deck, and on their turn, they can do one of two things. They can play a minion. A minion is easy to distinguish because they have a giant number up there, this saucy wench. Or they can play a special ability, like this broadside here, or they can do both. So, when you play a minion, you get to immediately do whatever it says. So, for example, it says before a base scores, you may move this minion there. So that's a special ability. I put that down, and whenever that happens, he can use that. But the saucy wench, on the other hand, when I place her, I can destroy a minion of power 2 or less at this base. So if someone else has played a minion there of 2 or less at that base, then I can destroy them. Then at the end of my turn, I draw two cards. Ooh, I'm starting to get the dinosaurs now. Laser atops and a rampage. Ooh, rampage. Anyhow, you're going to keep going back and forth around the table as you do this. Each of these bases here has a number up in the top left-hand corner. That number is called the breakpoint. And that breakpoint is once we have enough numbers here, total, of all the players playing minions at that website that equal or exceed 20, then we score that base. And first place will get this many points, 5, second place, 3, and third place, 2. We then will take that base off, put a new base on. All the minions are discarded, except for those that have special abilities that let them stay there and such. And we start another round. And we keep going until one player has gotten 15 points. At that point, the game ends, and that player is the winner. I would be mean if I didn't show you at least some more of the cards in this game. Here's the King Rex from the Dinosaurs. That's the most powerful card in the game. The biggest minion, but the dinosaurs are pretty powerful, and then the pirates, they can move minions around and they're fun to play with, and the bots are pretty weak, but you can play a whole lot of bots. Usually you can only play one, but the bots will let you get more out on the table. And the ninjas are just annoying. They're always destroying other people's things. If you like to attack other players, then you'll like to use the ninjas. The aliens are also kind of annoying, although the aliens have a few cards that just give you straight up a victory point. Maybe they're one of the weakest factions, but those free victory points certainly help in the long run. Zombies, which a lot of people are going to play simply because they're zombies, also let you get a bunch on the table and keep going and going and going. Then we have the Magicians, also called the Harry Potter group, which lets you play more cards, extra actions, and more minions. And then we have, they're called the Tricksters, but I call them a Leprechaun clan, because basically they're full of Leprechauns and Gremlins. And so those are just some of the factions that have come in the original one. There's 8 factions, so 28 different combinations, and each additional faction is going to essentially double the number of combinations that comes out, which is pretty neat. So we look forward to seeing what combinations will come in the future. So that's Smash Up. Now, one of the things people are going to like about Smash Up is simply the customization part of it. You can play Ninja Pirates if you so deign to break the laws of reality. But you can also play robot dinosaurs against wizard zombies, against, trickster pirates. There's all kinds of combinations. I mean, 28 combinations is a lot of different combinations. Is there one combination that's better than the rest? I don't know. But they all seem to be fairly balanced. The gameplay itself is very quick. It's very simple. You just play cards, boom, 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 and attack. There's not this huge amount of strategy here, but that doesn't detract the game simply being fun. Now, I found that the game suffers a little bit as a two-player game. It's much better as a three-player game. Because there's you have a choice of who to attack, a choice of what to go on. The bases end up going quicker, and there's a few quirks, like in a two-player game. One of the bases, for example, gives more points to second place. Well, no one ever goes there because if I go there, you'll let someone else build up and then quick toss in one of your minions to get second place. So third, the three-player works really well, and four-player also works well. Two-player's okay, but the even then, it's still fun. You're just playing lots of cards down. There's not this great, what should I do next? Usually it's pretty obvious what you're going to do. The artwork is fun. It's fast and furious. You probably get a game done very easily in 30 minutes. And so I think that's the kind of crowd. I think the King of Tokyo crowd is going to like this because it has that same kind of feel. There's no dice rolling in this, but that constant playing cards, ha-ha, and the combinations you can pull off, and just the bragging rights that you're the person who's using ninja zombies against somebody else. And it's going to be very entertaining, I think. I would imagine that we'll see probably 30 new factions in the next 2 years, which will increase the amount of combinations to infinity and beyond. So lots of fun. Smash Up is exactly what it advertises to be, a very light, fun Smash Up action game. Probably won't appeal to people looking for a heavy strategy game in any sense of the word, but if you're looking for that quick filler in between, I found it a lot of fun.
Thanks so much for watching the Dice Tower videos. Find more great videos and reviews, as well as our top-rated audio podcast at Dicetower.com. You can also find the latest board game news at DiceTowerNews.com. I'm Eric Summerer, and you've been watching The Dice Tower. The Dice Tower is sponsored by Fun Again Games, the world's best game source. Fun Again Games has over 5,000 games available. Check them out at FunAgain.com.